Hello, and welcome to 5 Minutes of Postgres. My name is Lucas, and today I want to start by saying thank you. This is episode 49 of 5 Minutes of Postgres, and almost a year ago, we started with the first episode. And back then, I wouldn't have believed if you told me we would get 1,000 subscribers on our YouTube channel, and this many people listening and commenting to each episode. So I really appreciate everyone's time in watching and learning more about Postgres, and giving me a good reason to look at what's new with Postgres every week. This is our last episode for the year, and we'll resume again next year in early January with 5 Minutes of Postgres on a regular weekly schedule. Today, we're going to talk about Union. This is a blog post that Laurenz wrote earlier this week about Union all and how it behaves with data types and how that can cause performance issues. I always appreciate Laurenz's posts because he goes into a lot of detail and tries to give you a good common sense of how to optimize your queries based on his own experience as a consultant. Now, this blog post actually referenced an earlier post that I want to give you a quick summary on. Back in 2018, Laurenz wrote a post where he said, you should avoid using OR. What he meant is that oftentimes when you have a query in Postgres, for example, querying a table and then saying this column equals this value or this other column equals this other value, then what Postgres will do in this particular case, it will choose to do bitmap heap scan across two different indexes. That can be fast, that can be slow. It depends a little bit on the particular situation. In this post back then, Laurenz described a particular situation that he considered to be really problematic where OR was not efficient at all. And what ended up happening is that he joined two tables and he said, give me the results matching that ID in one table or the ID in the other table. And we're joining those two tables with the same ID. Postgres picked a really odd plan here. It ended up doing an index scan without any condition, just scanning the whole index into memory and then doing merge join onto these two tables and using a join filter. Obviously, that's very slow. Back then, Laurenz recommended that instead of doing an OR condition in such a situation, you can actually use a union. You can rewrite your query and the plan is much better here. Two nested loops that then get union together and that will behave much faster. Earlier this year, Laurenz described a little bit more on whether this should be general guidance. Should we always be rewriting OR to a union? Because a lot of people asked him over the years, referenced this initial post. And so he generated two test tables again, inserted a bunch of values. And what he was comparing with here is for these two test tables, if I use union, is it going to get me the same result in all cases? And as he shows here, that's actually not the case. In this particular case, you cannot safely rewrite to a union because there is actually different behavior when there's duplicates. You shouldn't necessarily do this all the time, but you may choose to do union or union all to optimize your queries yourself. Earlier this week, he ran into an interesting problem here where he used union all, and the situation here was slightly different, essentially a form of polymorphism using different shaped tables and then creating a view across tables to query two tables together. He had three tables here, a bird table, a bat table, and a cat table. Bats and birds are flying animals, so they both have wingspans. And bats and cats are mammals, and so they have a body temperature. It's a simplified example of an actual real-world situation he ran into. He loaded a bunch of data for testing here, about 1 million rows for each of them. He also uses a lookup table, and the lookup table is the data that he's looking for, so the same set of IDs. In one case, he's querying a flying animal table. In the other case, he's querying a mammal table. These should behave the same way. Now, what's really strange here is you can see on the one table, it takes 380 milliseconds. On the other table, it takes 1 millisecond. And this is the same number of rows. Why is it slow in one case, but not the other? As always, you should look at explain plans. In the good case, Postgres chooses a nested loop. In the bad case, Postgres chooses a hash join. Laurenz was curious, why is that happening? And the gist of it is when Postgres has a union, that is a set of subqueries. And the Postgres planner has a method to pull up subqueries into the overall join tree. And that's necessary for the optimizer to then be able to use parameterized index scan in a situation like this. Laurenz is looking at the source here. If you have two different queries you're unioning, you must make sure that for subquery pull up to work, you need to not have any data type coercions. That means there are no casts that Postgres needs to do implicitly versus you doing it explicitly. The problem here is that the bird table had wingspan as a different data type than the bat table, in one case numeric, in the other case real. The way to fix that was to do an explicit cast to real on one of the tables. And that way they have the same data type and Postgres can choose the fast execution time. Thank you so much for listening. This was 5 minutes of Postgres. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to hear about the next episode. And I wish you happy holidays and a happy new year.